Hello friends, welcome to Healthy Bridge Bites. Let's cook and bake. Today we'll be seeing thandai powder with which you can make thandai or even cookies. No holi is complete without thandai. As holi is getting more popular in western countries, so thought why not make a fusion, thandai and cookies.
If you are new to my mom's channel, don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon.
Let's see the ingredients for instant thandai masala. 2 tablespoons of almonds, 2 tablespoons of cashews, 2 tablespoons of watermelon seeds, 2 tablespoons of rose petals. You can use either fresh rose petals, dried one, or rose water. 1 tablespoon of poppy seeds, 1/4 teaspoon of peppercorns, 2 tablespoons of pistas. You can increase peppercorns if you like the zing in your drink. So add it into a blender and blend it well with regular intervals, otherwise the nuts will start leaving its oil. So our thandai masala is ready now. So let's see the ingredients for cookies. 1 cup of whole wheat flour, 3/4 cup of raw sugar. You can increase or decrease according to your taste. Thandai masala, 1/4 cup. Milk, 2 tablespoons. Butter, 1/4 cup. Baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon. Baking soda, 1 pinch. So first we'll soak the thandai masala. I have added few strings of saffron, that's optional. Add 2 tablespoons of milk and allow it to soak. Soaking will enhance the taste. Mix well and set it aside. In a bowl, take butter, it should be at room temperature. This is 1/4 cup butter or 60 grams of butter. Add raw sugar, also known as khansari sugar or popularly known as khand in northern India. I have grinded the sugar in the mixie jar to make a fine powder. Blend the butter and sugar together until it becomes a creamy consistency. Scrape in between. It should become light in color and fluffier. You can even use a hand whisk. You can see now it has become very pale in color, fluffier, almost doubled its size and creamy consistency. At this stage, you can add your flour, whole wheat flour. Add some grated nutmeg to add some extra flavor. This is completely optional. Add baking powder and baking soda and mix gently. While mixing, you should be really careful. You shouldn't apply any pressure, otherwise the cookies will become very chewy. Now add the thandai masala which we have soaked in milk. Mix well. And by using hand, combine the dough. Do not knead. This will make the cookies chewy. Just combine the dough together. If you think it is too soft or too watery, you can add 1 tablespoon of whole wheat flour, or you can refrigerate for half an hour and then start making the cookies. I have preheated my oven at 160 degree with both the rods on. Take small balls and make a thumb impression for garnishing. I have taken some thandai masala, few chopped nuts and some rose petals and soaked in 2 teaspoons of milk, so it sticks very nicely to the cookies and it doesn't get burnt. Prick some holes in between the cookies so garnish with thandai masala and rose petals. This is completely optional. You can even place a cashew or an almond. Once it's done, place it in the preheated oven in the middle rack for 18 to 20 minutes. Our cookies are done now. We'll transfer it into a cooling rack and allow it to cool down completely. To make thandai milk, soak 2 tablespoons of thandai powder in milk and allow it to rest for 2-3 hours. And then add cold milk and sweetener of your choice and garnish it with dry fruits and rose petals. And your thandai is ready. If you like my video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel.